Hi there! Welcome to another episode of the Google Ads API Developer Series on Working with REST. I'm Laura Chevalier, and I'm a Developer Relations Engineer on the Google Ads API. In this episode, we're going to look at how to use the Google Ads Mutate method for grouped mutates over REST. First, we'll see an overview of the Google Ads Mutate method, and then we'll walk through a demo using curl. If you'd like to follow along with the demo, make sure you have your Google Ads API credentials ready to authenticate. The Google Ads service allows us to mutate multiple different resource types in a single request. We go into a bit more detail on Google Ads API mutates over REST in our video on resource-specific mutates, but let's do a quick recap here. Mutates in the Google Ads API are sent as post requests, and in general, they can create, update, or remove an entity in your ads account, though the exact functionality depends on the resource. Lastly, the mutate method is not available for all resources. You can use the REST interface documentation to help establish whether a resource has a mutate method and what the mutate operation includes for that resource. Whereas the REST URL for a resource-specific mutate includes the resource name for that resource, minus the resource ID, grouped mutates with the Google Ads service always use the Google Ads resource instead of a specific resource type like campaigns or assets. You might be wondering, why would I want to use the Google Ads mutate method instead of using a resource-specific mutate method directly? The Google Ads mutate method offers a few features over calling those methods directly. First, the entire request fails if a single operation fails, unless the partial failure field is set to true, which has the benefit of avoiding an inconsistent state. Second, the Google Ads mutate method allows you to use temporary resource names so that you can create a resource and reference that resource in the same request. For example, you might first create a campaign with resource names set to customers/123/campaigns/-1, and in the same request, create an ad group assigned to this campaign. Lastly, grouped mutates allow for fewer round trips to the API compared to a series of sequential mutate calls. There are a few caveats to the functionality here. First is that only resources that support atomic transactions are mutable through this endpoint, so Google Ads mutates can't replace all calls to individual services. Have a look at the REST reference docs to see which resources are supported. Second is that the order of the temporary resource IDs makes a difference. Resources must be created with a temporary resource name before the resource name can be referenced by another object. Further, each distinct temporary name must use a unique negative number, even for different resource types. Third is that the order is important for optimization. Be sure to group mutates by resource type, or the request could take longer than necessary and risk timing out. Before we move on to the demo, let's take a look at the structure for the data we send in a Google Ads mutate request. We start with our base object, which contains a mutate operations array. Each mutate operation in the array is a wrapper for a resource-specific operation object. In this case, we'll be working with campaign operation and ad group operation objects. If you followed along with our resource-specific mutates demo, you'll notice that the objects here are nested more deeply. That's because the resource type can't be inferred from the REST URL. With grouped mutates, we have to specify the resource-specific operation for each mutate operation. Then, in addition to the resource-specific operation object, we specify what type of mutate it is. For example, whether it's a create, update, or remove operation. And the value for that field is the resource object we're mutating. At the root level of our request object, you can also set the partial failure and validate only fields, which both default to false. If partial failure is true, successful operations will be carried out and invalid operations will return errors. If false, all operations will be carried out in one transaction if and only if they are all valid. If validate only is true, the request is validated but not executed, so the request will return only errors, if there are any, but no results. Now that we have a better understanding of how the Google Ads mutate method works, let's see it in action. For our demo, we'll create a search campaign and add an ad group to that campaign in the same request. I've gone ahead and set a variable REST URL to the URL we saw earlier using my customer ID and the resource name component. Now let's create a JSON file that we can pass as data in our curl request to that endpoint. We can call the file groupedmutates.json. As we just saw, we start with a base object containing a mutate operations array. In that array, each mutate operation object contains a resource-specific operation object. We'll start with the campaign operation, since that has to come before the add group operation, which will make a reference to the resource name we give here. Specifically, this is a create operation. And now we need to specify the fields in our campaign object. I'll set the name to awesome campaign. We'll set status to paused. Advertising channel type to search. Campaign budget to the resource name of an existing budget. And target spend, which I can leave as an empty object. So far, it's not so different from the campaign creation JSON from our resource-specific mutates video, except that it's nested another level deeper. But we've come to another distinguishing feature. With resource-specific mutates, the resource name field was output only. Here, instead, we use the resource name field to give our temporary name that we'll reference in our add group object to tie the add group to this campaign. So we set the resource name to customers slash the customer ID slash campaigns slash -1. Quick reminder here that if we needed to use multiple temporary resource names, we would need to use a unique negative number for each one, even if the resource type is different. An easy way to do this is to auto-decrement the ID each time you create a new temp resource name. That's it for our campaign object, so now we need to create the add group operation. Again, we wrap it in a base object, and then specify the resource-specific operation type. Here it's add group operation. Now within that add group operation object, we specify that this is a create operation. Next, we create the add group object. We can set the name to awesome ads, status is paused, type is search standard, since this is a search campaign, and CPC bid micros, which is the maximum cost per click bid where 1 million is equal to 1 unit, we'll set to 10 million. Now we set the campaign field, which will be the same temporary resource name that we gave to our campaign up above. Once the campaign is created, it's assigned a permanent resource name, which is included in the response object. Now you could add any number of additional campaigns, add groups, or other resources. Just remember to group by resource type to avoid performance issues, and to order the objects so that temporary resource names are created before they are referenced. For the sake of the demo, we'll save the file with just our campaign and add group operations. And now we can put together our curl request. So that's curl. I'll pass my access token. The developer token. The login customer ID. The content type. Then we pass in our JSON file as data. This is a post request. And we're posting to the URL that we determined earlier. So we run this. And it works. We get back a JSON object containing the resulting resource names of the campaign and the ad group that we created. That concludes our demo. Feel free to comment any questions below or reach out to us through our support channels. As always, I hope you found this video useful, and thanks for watching.